Battle suit activated. Maximum gain.
Hi, I'm VTech and this is my IGPU test of Styx Shards of Darkness.
That many guards in one place must be a whorehouse.
Even better, it's the guard's monthly payroll delivery.
A delivery of vegetables, more our style.
Let the pro do the hard work, then it's easy pickings for us.
That's disgusting.
What was I thinking when I took a job in this scummy rat hole?
Watch your ass!
What? You pushed me, you drunken piece of shit!
Thief! Thief! Raise the alarm! A thief got in!
Alarm! Oh, alarm!
Get me out of here, damn it!
Hi there. I'm the new accountant.
Let the pro do the hard work. Smoking's bad for you, boys. Real bad.
For several decades, the people of the Empire have been fighting to stem the invasion of goblins, the Green Blab. To contain the source, the humans have created squads specialized in the extermination of goblins, the Carnage. But it takes more than that to worry Styx, who now lives in the shadows of the human village, Tom, a slum populated by cooks of all kind and stuck in the middle of the swamps. His talents have earned him some renown, and an old scoundrel named Efron has recently contacted him for a tailor-made job, stealing the caskets containing the guard's pay.
It's been a while since I've been in this part of Thul. There's nothing left standing. You've turned into a real shithole. Proud of your work. No wonder the Greenskins ain't welcome around here. Gone, beat it, Rakash. Can't stand staring at your stupid face any longer.
So no worry, this is not gonna be a let's play. This is an IGPU test. So the most important thing first, my settings. The resolution is set at 1280x720, distance of display is weak. The field of view is in the middle at default. I set it a little bit higher, but you can set it however you want it to be. Anti-aliasing is set to average, post-processing weak, shadows weak, textures high, effects weak, and resync is activated. So, this doesn't look that bad. I think it's okay for this game. But we have a little problem, and that's the performance. In this scene at beginning, where I'm standing right now, we have around 24 FPS. That's not going much higher. There still scenes later where I make all my FPS test, where we only got 21 FPS, and that isn't even the weakest iGPU. I highly recommend that you play this game only if you have an iGPU with 1100 MHz or 1150 MHz or even higher if you have a K-CPU and be able to overclock it. If you have a lower iGPU, you still can download the demo version and lower the resolution to 720 to 480 and the game will run at more stable 30 FPS, so still be playable, but this doesn't look good anymore. As I said before, just download the demo, try this resolution for yourself, and if you say okay, the gameplay is really cool and the graphic doesn't matter that much for me, it's playable. The good thing I have to say about this game is, even if we are in this scene here, we are one now, I have around 28-27 FPS. I don't know how this game does it or what the developers have done or implanted a special technique, but this game, even if you have only 28, 30, maybe sometimes 35 FPS, really feel fluid when you are running and moving around. So I have other games, most times shooters, like one of my tests I'm also doing at the time right now from Sniper Ghost Warrior 2, which not feels that fluid and smooth even with 40 or 50 FPS like this game does with around 25 to 30 FPS. But different players have a different feel of smoothness, and some maybe need 60 FPS or 120 FPS to really can enjoy the play, so just download the demo and try for yourself. And yeah, the game, it's a stealth game. So another good thing, you don't run most of the time like I do here at the beginning, because later there are the enemies, so you will the most time sneak around, hide and wait for perfect times to sneak around the guards. You don't even need that high FPS. A really nice thing on this game is the character you're playing. It sticks. It's no superhero saving the world hero like Sam Fisher, for example. You're playing this badass thief goblin. I like him very much. This is just a demo, but when I have more time, I will definitely get this game and play it, because the demo really was nice to play. Even if the game is no open world game and the level design is very linear, you always have two or three options to get some missions done.
Well, this is gonna be competence for attacking, reaping, neutralizing, and annihilating all goblins to be eradicated. C-A-R-N-A-G-E. Crappy name. They must have been paying the guy who wrote it by the letter. They're really scraping the barrel if they're recruiting here in Shitville Thoban. Given the scum that live around here, better tear down these posters. Otherwise, this little toilet of paradise will turn into a real stinking hell.
In this house you can get over three ways. The first is you can distract the guards inside here. This door is normally locked, but when you make some noise outside, the guards come out and open it for you, and then it stays open and you can get in. Or you can sneak by to the back side around these two guards. We also have here two options. One, we make some noise here upstairs and the guards will come. And when they stay under us, we lower this and they will be dead. Or we just put it down, distract them and can sneak by them. And here you can go onto the roof or you sneak through this hole into the house. A lot of ways to get things done, and this is really cool. If you have sand in your pocket, which you can sometimes collect from the floor, like here, you can turn off torches from the distance.
I should be able to put together some nasty surprises.
You see what we found during the last raid?
Yeah, nice one. I was sure it had disappeared since the fall of Akinash.
Me too. We'll make
so
a
here
ton
I
of
poison this
it.
Food and go back inside where's a docking.
Of course. What are you taking me for? I hid it in the old secret room.
Huh. One behind the bookcase.
Shh. Why not just the rooftops?
So this is a workbench to craft things if you have the right items collected. The one guard went away. Now we have to wait that the second guard here eats something and hopefully will die. So let's put out the torch. Get the item and this paper, and these two
it's
items are everywhere in this level and get you points at the end.
Good luck.
So the two guards have talked about a hidden bookcase which is hidden here, so we use a book and open it and can get some nice stuff.
That's a rare vintage.
So you should always listen to the talks of the guards to maybe find a secret dash. We sneak by. On this bed there's an item, but we don't have to collect all items. Guard patrols, so we get this item and the other guard sleeps, so no problem. And up we go. So now we have to wait. And as I said before, when we were on the backside, we would also be able to jump to the roof, and if we would do that, we would get in here. So you can see really a lot of ways. And that's the easy way here. You just can sneak by this guard unseen without problems. Don't have to open this door or sneak around.
Carnage is recruiting. There are squads hunting goblins in other places too.
These are two guards that you kill. You get points if a lot of guards stay alive at the end of a level. The other guard got distracted. Can sneak by. Grab this paper.
Got to get it out of here.
Gotta grab this item and hide until this guard is down. Move around the corner and we're ready to go to the next checkpoint. I grab this item because it's easy to get. Yeah, insect eggs. Don't know what to do with them. So, two guards here, just jump down and roll, in the case the guards would notice us.
Ah, the Silver Goblet! Used to be the best bar in this part of Thoban. Looks like the change of owner has brought in some not so fresh faces.
So here we can could take the barrel and kill the guard down here, easy. Or we just sneak by and let him live to get more points at the end of the mission. And here's the next house, which is the last one and contains the most guards in this game or in this level. And here you really have a lot of choices how you get into the house and get the items in there you need for the mission. You can kill all guards, you can go up over the roof into the house, you can sneak in this little, I don't know how to call it, tunnels. Or you can use this warp and get down to the first room, where you have a payment case to collect. And you don't have to kill this guard. I think you can kill 5 guards and getting the full points at the end, so I just kill him because it's easy. If I get noticed from a guard upstairs, I can go up down here and be safe. I don't have to worry that this guard will see me. So we just grab all. Ah, the first guards pay.
Call of Booty. It's even better.
With the iron we found, we go off to another dart. But because trying to sneak here, we don't really need it. But it can be useful if you have a guard you want to kill later.
Have you heard about the Tolkien?
So the two are Tolkien.
Yeah, but I don't really believe it.
And the one guard, he is sleeping, so we can easily get this paper and this item and go upstairs without problems.
Those filthy parasites are a pain in the ass, and there's too many of them.
And if they start understanding what we say as well as wrecking the place, I don't even want to think about it.
I'm not going to think about it. I'd rather just go and join Carnage.
And here too, you can use this to kill the guard down here, which is sleeping. So two doors here, which are also locked, and I've just found a BitLocker in this room, so I could open it, or I could take the third way in, so I don't waste the picklocking and can maybe use it later, where it is more useful. I can go up here, sneak through this window. Here again, you can kill this. I think it's not a guard, it's some merchant or maybe accountant. When he moves under this chandelier, I just can sneak by. So you take all these items while he is moving around. And sneak out the way you just moved in. Yeah, and that's the end of this test. If you're using my settings and you like them, please give me thumbs up, and if you do not want to miss my future videos, just subscribe to my channel.